In this video, we are going to discuss a problem related to controllability of a control system. In the last video, we discussed about controllability of a control system. Based on that, we are going to solve a problem. So here, observe the problem. Verify the controllability of a control system, which is represented by state equation x dot is equivalent to -1, -1, 1, 0, x1, x2, 1, 0, u. So whenever they are saying this is the state equation, we need to compare with the actual state equation, fundamental state equation, that is x dot is equivalent to ax plus bu. So this is the fundamental state equation that we need to compare with the given state equation. So why we are comparing this fundamental equation with the state equation means, so now our aim is to find out the controllability of the control system. So here we are going to follow Coulomb's test. So Coulomb's test. So in this Coulomb's test, we are having two steps. First step is to derive the matrix QC. How we can form this matrix QC, controllable matrix, means this is the formula. This we already discussed in the video where I am discussing controllability. B, AB, A square B and so on, A power n minus 1 into B. So like this we can form QC matrix. So where A and B are these variables and n represents order of the matrix A and B. So here coming to A, as I told you, A is always n by n matrix. Here this is 2 by 2 matrix and coming to here this is 2 by 1 matrix. So order is equivalent to 2, n by n, n by 1, where n is equivalent to 2. So by the given data, A is equivalent to -1, -1, 1, 0, this is the given data I am writing, and B is equivalent to 1, 0 and n is equivalent to 2. Now this matrix will become, so this is equivalent to, when I am taking n is equivalent to 2, this is limited to A power 2 minus 1, that means A power 1 into B, AB means it will limited to only 2 terms. So this matrix will be, for the given data, the matrix will be BAB. So now everything available with us, just to calculate AB is needed. So here I am just multiplying A and B. A and B is equivalent to A into B is equivalent to -1, -1, 1, 0 into B is equivalent to 1, 0. If you multiply these two, what you are going to get, you can see -1 into 1, -1, plus -1 into 0, 0. So totally you will get -1, and coming to this one, 1 into 1, 1, plus 0 into 0, 0. So AB you will get -1, 1. And already you are having B, so that is 1, 0. I am taking directly. So this matrix will be equivalent to B means 1, 0. And here AB means minus 1, 1. This is the QC matrix. He formed the QC matrix. The second Coulomb's test will be taking determinant of the QC matrix. So now the second step in Coulomb's test is to take determinant of QC. So if you are taking modulus of QC, then you need to take -1, 1, 0, 1 modulus AD minus BC. AD means it's equivalent to 1. Now if you observe this, determinant of QC is not equivalent to 0. This is not equivalent to 0 means the system is controllable. We can say the system is controllable. For example, in any other problem, if you got this determinant is equivalent to 0, then we can say the system is not controllable. So this is an example for controllability of a control system. Generally, we need to consider columns test to define the controllability of a system. First, we need to form a matrix QC by the state equation given like this. According to the order, the number of terms are limited in the matrix, and after that, when you are ready with this matrix, you need to find out the determinant. So, if the determinant is not equal to 0, then only your system is controllable. Otherwise, you can say your system is not controllable. For now, for this example, the example control system given here with this state equation is purely controllable system.